My name is Sudhir Verma, and I am an open source developer, and I work as an associate software engineer in Red Hat. So my Twitter account is this, Sudhir Verma, and I have shown in the GitHub ID Sudhir Verma, and this is my email ID. So if you have any question, you can email me. So basically, it's a desktop application which is supported on Linux, Windows, and Mac. So there are 18 to 19 components in we have provided for installation. So it's so there are few steps you have to follow, and everything will be installed on your Windows and Mac and Linux. So yeah, what we are using to build a desktop application. We are using Electron for building a desktop application. It's a Chromium browser, and user interface is AngularJS and Patternfly. Backend we are using is Node.js. So I will show you the demo also, how we are installing. Yeah, so how it is useful for other, means for users. You just have to follow a few steps. There are few steps, and you have to follow it, and everything will be done for you, means it will be installed on your system. So, and there are few 18 components, so whichever you want to install, you have to select that. And for dependency, suppose you are installing so it's a dependency is JDK. If you select JBoss, then automatically JDK will also install on your system. And features are desktop application installer. It's detect whether it is updated or not. If there is any new version available, so it will check that you are using a old version or new version. If you are using old version, it will show you that you can update it by clicking on the link, and your application will get updated. And there are highly categorized component. There are five highly categorized component. For first one is all, that you can select everything. Second is JDK, Java environment. You can select Java product and you can install it. And the next one is container. For example, CDK, Minishift, VirtualBox, you can install it. And there are three more which I will show you in demo. And detection, yeah. So, sorry. If there is a detection process is also there, we are storing all the download file in cache. So first time you have to it will download, it's around 3 GB of data which will be downloaded on your desktop. And after that, when you run next time, it will pick up from your cache next time. So, and it shows the download progress also. If it is a 3 GB data, then it will show you how much. Yeah.
You might if we try this at home, because 3 GB is quite a lot to download here.
Yeah, there are 19 components, and so
increase. You just show us how to do it.
You want to see demo?
Yeah, we'll try that out. So
I mean, you're going to do demo anyway, right?
Yeah, right.
Okay, what he's saying is, I mean, you already have the cache in you.
Yep.
Already has the cache.
Okay. So I'm not going to download it. Yeah. And yeah, the last one is storing cache for further use. Yeah, platform supported is RHEL 7, Windows 7, 8, and 10. And what happened?
Okay,
yeah, and the macOS, which is 10.11 and above.
Okay, so
yeah.
Understand. Not all distros are available for this one.
Sorry?
Not all distros. It looks like only Red Hat. Only Red Hat 7.
Yep, Red Hat 7.
Okay, so we can't try that one.
Yeah, you can try it on Fedora also. Minishift you can manually try. But we are supporting for RHEL 7 if you are using our product.
CentOS 7.
Yeah, it will install on CentOS also. So this is an open source product, and you can check it out, our product here. So we have our code is available on GitHub. This is the Red Hat platform tooling. So here we have provided all the components. It's loading. Yeah. So here are the products, Dev Studio. I will show all these components in demo also. Yeah. Yep. So if you want to download the built file, you can download it from developer.redhat.com. So our exe file is there, and you don't have to pay for using our product. It's totally free. You just have to log in. You can register on the developer.redhat.com and log in, and you can download it. Yeah, so here it is, Red Hat developer development suite. This is the product which will provide all the installation for the product. And next one, I will show you the demo for installation. I will run the exe file. I have downloaded from the developer.redhat.com. Sorry? Okay, I will show you this way only. So this is the version. Due to screen share, it's not looking good. So this is the development suite which is updated already. And next, this is, you can select where you want to install. For it is not installed already, so it will show you that the selected folder will create will be created. New one folder will be created. So we are using a Electron for this. Now it is checking whether other components are installed or not. If it is installed, then it will show that it is detected and disable it. We will disable that product. So we are, for detection, we are using a PowerShell and a registry, window registry, so that we can check whether the JDK or any other product are installed there or not. Yep. So I was talking about the highly categorized channel. So first one is all. So in first, in all, you can select all the components. For now, it's showing that I have selected only 6 components, and total available are 19. So there are container development, created the JBoss Developer Studio, OpenJDK, Red Hat Container CDK, and Compose or Oracle VirtualBox, and the last one. Cygwin for Windows, and Java, we have specified the Java development product only. So I am selecting few components for installation. I will select a Java development kit. So next, so only I am installing three products: Red Hat JBoss Developer Studio and OpenJDK its dependency, and Compose I am installing. So if you don't have the account, for then you just have to register from your personal email ID or any other email ID you can use. And we are using the keytar to store the user information in their environment, in their desktop, and it is, and you can't user can other people can't see your password also. Basically it is not installed on the cloud, so it's safe. So yeah, previously I have downloaded all the product, so it's now checking whether it is already downloaded or not from cache.
So you mentioned it resolves all the dependencies, right?
Yeah. So now it's installing. JDK was dependency of JBoss. Yeah.
So last, without this suite, development suite, last time we have to download one at a time.
Yeah.
Download a JDK, download a with this, it just downloads everything and installs.
Yeah. Last time it was having all the product was shown on the installation part. JDK, Compose, and
Yeah. Oh, everything has to be downloaded.
Not everything. At the installation time, all three will be shown here. Now we have just shown the one single bar here, progress bar.
No, I think even before this software was developed, this installing software was developed, we would have to go and download all three one by one. Am I right?
No.
No need.
No need.
I mean, this was there from day
one. Yeah. So it's take time for installation JBoss.
So once installed, then we can just use.
Yeah.
So that's your demo.
And I will show how we are created the exe file also, to open a PowerShell file to uninstallation.
To uninstall.
Yeah. So I will show how we have created the registry, Windows registry, and we are installing all the product, uninstalling. I can show you the code also, how we are installing. I can tell you that also after this demo. At the end, on the final page, we are providing a link so that you can directly open the JBoss Developer Studio after installation. And if some error occur, then we have provided the default text editor, which will be shown here. You can just open it and see what goes wrong when it's failed.
So this particular application is all the development applications done by Red Hat.
Yep.
And you just choose what you want.
Yeah. So where it is in, yeah. So it's completed, and this is the link we have provided so that you can open the JBoss. So it's, you will launch and your developer environment will be ready so that you can use it and develop a code. Here it is. Yeah, so now we have installed program file development. So here is all the file are generated here, Dev Studio, JDK and Compose. Through registry we have provided the, we have created this Red Hat development suite. Double click, it will open a PowerShell, then it will uninstall. So it's showing we have developed one more feature. I have already opened the JBoss, so it's showing that file is locked, so you have to exit it. So now it's uninstalling every product. First, it's uninstalling JDK. I will show you the code also for this. And it will remove the parent directory also.
Yeah. The registry as well.
For that product only it will remove. So now it's removed the parent folder also for development. So we have used the power. Yeah, so here we are checking, this is the code for uninstallation of all the product. This is the code for checking the log file which we have seen before. Yeah, so next we are checking the if open JDK installation. We have put the condition.
So for every application?
No, no. For few application we have put, because it's create a shortcut file also on Windows. So we have to remove that also. So for 3-4 components we are uninstalling. For other product we are just removing the folder, so it will not detect that. And Sigwin also create a shortcut file for this. And for removing from the registry we are using this remove item path, and this is the code for removing from the registry, development suite and time span we have provided how much time it take at the installation time, so it's removed from there also. And code for creating setting up the developer environment, so I will show you the compose part. Yeah, this is the part for installation. So for compose directory we are checking at the first time it's create, we are checking the name compose directory from the requirement.json. We are taking the name and the installation at the first time you seen that there is a step to select the folder. That folder and the key name will come here, and it will create a directory for that. And for this code is used, we are using to check the progress status, success and failure. If success is done, then we will show the final page. If there is any error, then we will show the text editor so that you can find the error. And we are copying the file in the download file, and this is the code for changing the name of compose part file. Basically it provide a compose for a Mac, we are providing a compose, and for Windows.exe we are giving the name. And after that we are making the file executable so that you can use it. If all the promise get resolved, then it will go to succeed, and if there is any failure, then it will go to exception. So for compose, this is the installation step, and you can check also whether compose is installed or not. Oh, I have uninstalled the product, so it's showing that it is not there. Yep. So any question for installation and registry part? No. So we are creating a registry. I will show you the code also for registry, how we are saving the registry part. This is the code for in Windows registry. For now we are removing this uninstallation, and we are providing the electron based on it, and it will show a UI for you all, and you can select which you want to uninstall. So we are this part is under progress. Yeah, no question. Yeah. So thank you.